In this day and age, if you have a computer, a tablet, a cell phone, you probably have a whole bunch of different cables to hook them up and charge them. You probably have fistfuls of adapters so you can hook things up to your gear. That's a problem for me and my workflow. What do you do with these things when you're not using them? It's probably a problem for you too, and it needs to be solved.
My name is Eric Strebel. I'm an industrial designer. Welcome to my channel about product design and making. I hope that you like, enjoy, and become a subscriber.
I considered some of the cable holders that are available online made out of bent sheet metal, but they didn't really suit my needs as they were too wide or didn't hold the cables the way I wanted. I even downloaded something from the internet, but the little fingers were spaced too far apart. So I did this initial sketch based on those other things you just saw, but it was a little too wide for me, and I wanted something that was stacked on top of itself so that it could work in the space that I need it. And in this case, it's going to be my vocal booth. So right now in my vocal booth, the little adapters just hang out on the shelf where my keyboard is, and they get in the way and fall on the floor, and that's no good. There's a link here in the top right to the full-length version of this sketch that I'm doing right now. Okay, so this is our plan. So normally I would probably make a cardboard model, and I would love to do that in this case to sort of get a sense of the scale, but I'm in a time crunch with other projects, and so we're gonna build this in CAD and 3D print it. So even though this will take longer, quite a bit longer, to make a model, it's gonna consume less of my actual physical time to do this. So let me explain this. It takes me maybe an hour to model it in the computer, at which point the printer will then take 15 hours, let's say, to print out the two parts at a decent resolution. If I didn't go this route, I would go right into making a cardboard model. Maybe that would take me 3-4 hours, and boom, I would be done. Maybe I might make a final one out of styrene. It would still be less total time, if that makes sense. But due to other projects, I need to go this route. And that sometimes happens, and you have to manage your time that way when you're doing different design projects. Thank you. Now, my buddy Alex gave me a spool of PolySmooth. He doesn't own an Ultimaker and for some reason had a spool that fits the Ultimaker. Don't know. PolySmooth, you say, what is that? So PolySmooth prints like PLA. I use the exact same settings, but it reacts with alcohol. And here I'm laying down some 70% isopropyl alcohol to kind of test things out. And basically what it does is it melts the plastic. Now, I didn't have a lot of luck with the 70%, but then I moved to stronger alcohol, 91%, and I got much better results and the surface started to get a little bit shiny.
All right, so just after applying the 90%, 91%, you can see it's definitely more glossy.
Now, the alcohol softens the plastic and it stays in a soft state for a little while, so you have to let it dry, but basically it smooths out the high spots and the low spots and you get a smooth surface.
Now it's definitely a lot more brittle. I broke one and it wasn't too hard, so I don't think it's nearly as tough as the PLA.
Granted, the build line is going exactly in the direction that I broke it in, so it's a little tough to say. Do I think it's worth it? Not really. Reminds me of the old resin printer days, and I'm done with that. But if you need a smooth print, it may be the way to go. Wow, so this turned out really, really good. Great place to store my cables with all my little adapters on the top. I'm gonna post a link below to Thingiverse where I'm posting the STL and step file for this so you can print one out for yourself and hopefully it'll be useful for you as well. Leave a link in the comments if you're gonna print one out and post on social media at Bots and Design so I can see what color you made it and where you used it. I'm probably going to print two more, one for the shop and one for the studio where my computer lives. Now make sure you give the video a thumbs up and feel free to promote on your social media platform of choice. That is really going to help me grow the channel the most with your support. Thank you. Make sure you give the video a thumbs up and don't forget to subscribe if you haven't already done so. Hey, and don't forget to follow me on social media. I'm on Facebook sometimes, Twitter usually, and now Instagram. Rock on. Click here to check out some of the other design and making videos that I have that you might enjoy.